What's up, everyone? How are we doing? We're back on North March. I always get the name of the map confused. It is July 1st, and guess what? It's time to harvest. You guys can see I've made 373,000. If we go here, I've been doing a shit ton of contracts. But if you go here, I have some property income from something on the farm. I haven't figured out what exactly it is because I can't pinpoint it. And then you guys can see here contract income. So May, June, I didn't have anything because I've had finished all the billing contracts. So that is where my money has come from. So you guys can see that. So what we need to do today is we're going to lease a harvester. We're going to go over here. Is there anything in here that I want? No. Actually, no, I don't want that. So we need to go up here to harvesters, and I kind of want to stick with, because right now we have a Kloss tractor. I kind of want to stick with that. So I think I'm going to stick with Kloss. I think that's what we're going to go with for this map. It's a very, very, I like their machines. So we're going to get, I don't know if I need 15,000 liters. We're going to get this one. It's the Trion 750-720. So we're going to put the big grand tank on it because I don't think I'm going to need any more than 12,000 for right now. And then Michelin. And then we're going to go with the Conveal Flex 1080. I'm just going to turn up the working speed on that because it's a small header. It's only 10.8 meters. I'm going to try and get it down the road. If I can't get it down the road, then we'll put it on a... Then we'll put it on a header trailer, but I'm going to try and put it... Try and take it down the road to the farm. Or not to the farm. To my fields. So... Yeah, I'm going to already say this now. I'm going to need the header trailer. So... down to let's see, hydro trailer is right here, and I'm gonna use this one. I think it's wide enough. It looks wide enough. Sorry, my computer was having a little bit of a meltdown there for a second. And then we're going to try and put this on here. Just like that. Alright. Now, you can put these on low loaders as well. But I don't have a semi-truck, so... Very, very careful. So if you look at the map here, fields, let's see. So fields 57, 11, and 73 are ready to harvest, and then I have two fields down here as well that are also ready to harvest. S and I think that's it. Yes, that's it. So we'll do these three, and then we'll do these two. For trailers, I do have a trailer. I don't know if I'm going to get a different one. Side view here of the cab. Alright, so we're coming up on my first field right here. Love how the machine just moves. So I'm gonna start in this corner here, do a headland around the field first. Come back and we'll do 73. I want to get the two smaller ones done first. Or get this one done first at least. Alright. So this is my field. Make that, let me start over again. I have enough stuff to make TMR to start cows. And now I have straw. The only things I'm missing are the machines. And I can easily get those when I need them, or I can just buy them outright. So I think that's where we're gonna go, is we're going to start with cows today. And we're not gonna get a lot, we're gonna just get a couple. And we'll see how things go. You know, they will start producing a little bit of milk and slurry. Milk won't be for a while, but they'll definitely be producing slurry. And I think now is probably just the best time to start them, because like I said, I have the stuff. And it should last me until I get more billing contracts at the end of the year. So that's also a plus. They're kind of just a waste if I just let them sit there. So I want to say I have close to 20 bales of each, which is enough to make a decent amount of TMR. I can't even say how much I'd make, but it'd make a lot. At least if I remember correctly. I would say it's probably enough for 2 or 3 batches of TMR. And depending on the feed mixer, you know, that's 30,000 liters is a lot. You know, if you don't have that many cows, once we get more cows, 50, 60, 100, then we'll need to upgrade our TMR production a lot more. I also stopped doing contracts for the recycling center, because every time I'm at the recycling center, my machines would shut. So I'm not sure if it's something that I'm doing wrong or if it's a bug with the map. Next thing, and you guys can see here are the bales while I'm over here. So I don't have that many silage bales, and I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19. I got, like, if I count correctly, 19 silage bales and 2, 4, or 3, 6, 8, 12 hay bales. So I mean, I guess I had less than I thought, but that should still be enough to start TMR and, you know, get that going. And I made a little tent here because I didn't have. I'm just going to reset this, make my life a lot easier, because I hate driving back and forth. I know it looks better if I don't reset it, but. Okay, so I have a trailer in here. The problem is the trailer is only 22.5 meters. Liters. Not meters. Liters. I'm gonna sell that. We're going to sure if I was gonna do it, but we're gonna go and see what else we can find. Thirty-six is not that bad. I haven't used this one, the Big Body 750 Crampy trailer, or I don't know if I said that right. I've used it, but it's been a while. You know what? We'll leave the Michelin Agriculture Michigan special on there. Michelin, Jesus Christ, I cannot talk. So we'll buy that. And then, we'll take that back over, empty out the harvester. I was hoping for some barley contracts, but I didn't get any barley contracts, so I wanted to do chickens as well, but chickens only eat wheat and oats, so I don't know what I have for contracts available, but I don't think we're gonna do chickens. So whatever I get here today, I'm just going to sell right away just because I don't really have use for oats at all. Park this right here. Oh wait, do I have a horse? I don't have a horse paddock. I have cows, pigs, and chickens. See, if I had horses, we could do oats for horses, but I don't have any. I'll also be starting a new playlist. It's going to be my Start From Scratch playlist. And it's going to be on one of the newer maps. That will be coming out probably next week, I would assume, sometime. We'll be doing both this map and the new one. And then 57. And see 57. I was like, wait, what? Wait, I'm on 57. Sorry, 11. We'll go over to 11 and then field 75. Or 73. Happy Friday, guys. I am not all with it today. I do apologize. But you guys are probably used to that by now if you've seen any of my content. It's never a dull day when I make a video or stream. The yield off of this wasn't the best. It was okay. I mean, it was middle of the pack. But for the first field, it could have been a lot worse because all we did was fertilize. That's all we did. So for just fertilizing, we didn't do bad. So I'm going to try and get this across the bridge without the header on it, without the header trailer. But I don't know if I'll be able to, but we're going to try it. Actually, let me do field 11 first before I... It's not gonna fit. So let me go get the trailer, which is... Let's use the harvester, go get the trailer. It's over on 75. Part of that field we didn't do too bad, but the other part, because of the soil, and I think because we didn't have lime or anything else, it wasn't the best. Can't see if it has goddamn trees. To where my header is. The geese were there, and the duck scared the shit out of me. I was like, what the fuck's my header at? It's over here somewhere. You guys can tell I don't use header trailers that often. Thank you. jackknifing. There we go, alright. Actually, one thing about, let me see, when do oats sell the most for? Let's go up here. Oat. You know what? We could actually store them in the silo till. Because right now, 843 is the highest. And they sell for tops of 1,157 dollars, and that would be in January. So we could, because we don't need the money right now, we could technically save them. I just thought about that. I was like, why am I gonna sell these if we don't technically, we can make more money? Sense to me, at least. Too bad of a yield off this field either. I'd say between probably 50 and 70%. Some parts we're getting 120%. Of the video, we'll go back and we'll look back at how our fields turned out. So do keep in mind for seeding, when I get done with this, it won't be today, it'll be for another video. Keep in mind, crop rotation is also a thing that I have on now, so I have to be very thoughtful about the crops that I plant every year now, and make sure to rotate them so that the yield also, you know, the crop rotation will impact the yield otherwise. I will return to your video shortly. I have to go and take care of something really quick. Alright, we're back with the other half of the video. Sorry about that, guys. Let's finish this, and then I might be able to get the rest of this oat in this grain tank. Should be able to, at least. Finish this, we'll put it in the trailer. Depending on how full the trailer is, I might go sell it right away. Or go store it, not sell it. this. Oh, we got plenty of room in this trailer. Plenty and plenty of room in this trailer to finish this off. Hopefully. After Field 73, we might not. Field 73 is going to be a different breed of a field compared to these smaller ones. With a 10-meter header, that one might take a little bit. I'm going to probably do a headland on Field 73, and then I'm going to set a worker. Actually, I'm never going to... No, I'll be fine. I'm trying to decide if I want to do a headland and then start a worker on Field 73 while I go and take this to the grain silo. But I think we'll be fine. Shouldn't take me that long. Let me mark the grain silo, because I always forget where my farm's at on this map. I'm not used to it. So we have a farm silo right here. So let me put this back on the header trailer. Knock it off. So let's see. I think we need to go this way. I think. Shit. And the header fell off. God damn it. Now you guys see why I hate header trailers so much. Let's try this again. Looks like it's on there decent this time. Big field right over there. Now I just need to find a good place to park this. That's the next thing. And then, like I said, this one's gonna take a little bit, so that's why I'm going to hire a worker and have him do it while I'm taking the oats to the silo. Just don't know where I want to park this trailer at. Looks like my best place is gonna be right over here. start this, and then we'll put a worker on it. And go this way. All right, whatever. Let's go this way. Let him. All right, he's going. All right, we'll take this to the silo really quick. Right now we got 25,000 liters in the trailer. I'm not sure how much that grain tank will hold at the farm. I probably should have tried to figure that out, but I think we'll be okay. I'm pretty sure we'll be okay. It's not a super big tank, and the fields aren't super big, so should be fine. Shit. Oh, don't get stuck. Don't get stuck. It's stuck. Got it. I turned the wrong way, however. Should be up here. Not that one. I think I need to go to the left and turn down that road. I think. I was supposed to turn back there. Well, this is why I hate trees. Trees always get in my way. I always blame the trees. Where the fuck am I going? Should be. I know it's around one of these corners. It's not that way. Is it? There's my farm, but where the fuck's the entrance? This is what always throws me off about this farm, is finding the entrance. Because it's a very hidden entrance that's not. And the roads are very confusing. Aha! Here we go. I knew I'd get it eventually. Unload that. So now, if we go to Oach, you guys can see that we have 25,000 liters in the Grand Tank. I have fertilizer over there. Excess fertilizer, because I didn't have a place to store it, so I just put it there. Let me go this way. I'll go through my bunker silo. Alright, let's go back to my field, and looks like the worker is still going, so that's good. Oh god, I forgot the camera is different when you switch views. So because Field 73 is so big and we ran out of time, I'm gonna cut the video off here, and then I'll be back once we get the field done, and then we'll do 21 and 39. So I'll see you guys back here in a little bit. All right, guys, we're back. So I finished the field. We're not going to use the header trailer though. I think I'm going to try and rent a low loader, and we're going to see if we can fit this on the low loader, because the simple fact of it's very, very hard for me to operate header trailers. Looking for a decent one. Those all aren't that big. This is from the Platinum expansion. We could try this and see if it works. That looks to be the best bet. So we're just gonna rent this, and then we're gonna rent a semi. I'll do the super line 6x4. If this doesn't work, then I'll have to use the header trailer. Shit, that does not get towed by a truck. Let's see. Do this one. Oh, that's for shipping containers. Well, reset the tractor and see if I can pull it with that. I've never really used a low loader before, so it's something new I wanted to try. I just don't know if the harvesters are gonna fit, that's my only thing. Wonder if they have any flatbeds and trailers. I know I download some flatbeds, I just don't know where they would be. That's a pallet all load trailer, that's not what we want. Although that is big enough. Maybe. Miscellaneous. Nope. That's the wrong one. Let's see. Nothing here. Maybe the flatbed chairs were just for bales. Well, let's see if we can do this. If not, I'll use the header trailer. Bring this up here. I'm going to try and see if I can maneuver this on the trailer. Yeah, there ain't no way this thing's gonna fit. Well, that's one way to put it. Oh boy. Yep, okay, that did not work as planned. So we are going to just I knew as soon as I put that harvester on there that was gonna be a disaster, so we'll have to get the header trailer and use that instead. Here, I thought I could try something different and it would work out, but as soon as I put the harvester on the trailer, I'm like, oh yeah, this is not big enough and it's not gonna work. I should nickname this video Harvester Disaster. That wasn't that big of a disaster, could have been worse, I guess. All right, let's go over here. So I got this field done. As you can see, the yield wasn't too bad for the most part. It was really good. We'll check out the yields when we get done with the last two fields. We have quite a bit of oat in the grain tank at the silo. So we have 100,500 liters, of oat right now, which is a ton off of 3 fields, which is actually very, very good, in my opinion. This. I'm not gonna take the tractor over there. That'll be for the trailer. Let's put the harvester over here on this bad boy, and then we'll hitch the tractor back up to the grain trailer. One thing I've been having issues with on this map is sending workers like to do deliveries for me. That's one thing I've been having issues with. I'm not sure if it's just me or if the workers this year are just not that good or if it's something with the map. I know workers have been a bit touch and go between this one and 19, so it's a possibility that might be the issue. It's just workers not wanting to work. So we'll do 21 and then we'll do 39. Then I'm gonna sell those two. And on the next episode, we'll be doing cow stuff. Getting those in order. Actually, I probably could have kept on going that way, but oh well. Sure the heather is still back there. Because of my driving, who knows how long I can stay on. Ooh, shit. Just like that. Oh, nope, it stayed on. Alright. This is not where I wanted to go. Let's fix the header really quick. Maybe. Just fold this for right now. Until we get to where we need to go. Which is right over yonder. And picking up straw, so I'm not gonna sell the two fields right now. I'm gonna use that straw before I sell the two fields. So next episode we'll be doing some baling for the fields. I won't do it this episode. So this episode I will wind up with me putting the rest of the grain into the grain tank. And then next episode we'll be baling, selling the two fields, and hopefully starting cows in that episode. Keyword hopefully. Baling shouldn't take too long because we're only doing straw, and straw bales get made rather quickly. It's not like hay or silage. Before I forget, let me bring this guy over to the farm because he's almost full. So I'll show you guys what I mean when I try and hire a worker. So let me go here. Let's click on this guy. Let's see. Deliver. Non-looping. And see, it doesn't go. And I don't know why. I feel like I'm doing something wrong. Start, and then that should be it, but it's unloading station is full. I don't understand that. Okay, well, whatever. I guess I'll do it myself. Yeah, I don't usually hire workers because unless it's a big field that they can, you know, plow or harvest or fertilize or whatever the case may be, because I can never get them to work like I want them to. And I think that's one of my biggest flaws with this game, is just the workers don't really, they're kind of dumb. Windshield, you need to clean the whole tractor. So I'm very excited to see where this journey is gonna take us. I wanna get more cow pens. I wanna try and do a big herd of cows. I don't know if that's gonna be possible on this map, but that's one thing I wanna do. The other thing is I'd love to do a big silage harvest on this map. That'd be great. We have all that fertilizer for fertilizing contracts and fields when it comes time next year, so that'll save us some money. Well, this year, actually. I also built a lime silo, as you guys can see. Had a construction company come in and do that. So now, probably should have went the other way. Oh, that's okay. We can go around this way. So now I can take this all the way down to our next area, which is field 26. Seven, or maybe not, because it's not a straight shot. But following the rule, I should be able to get there. This map's very confusing and lots of twists and turns. I'm used to the American-style maps where they don't have a lot of twists and turns and windy corners. So it's a little bit of a change from what I'm used to, which is good. The tire smack a tree. That will never change. Here we are. Alright, let's start this guy back up and finish the field. Probably over my time limit already. I've been trying, like I said, I've been trying to keep track of my videos. But it's so hard to show you guys everything. I need to master showing you guys, like, harvesting and then speeding it up. I gotta get used to doing that. That's one thing that I wanna start doing. Instead of just cutting out what I'm doing. Front view of the harvester. And then I also have some. I'm not gonna do it on camera, but I have some more straw bales that I'm gonna sell. I just have to try and figure out how to get them all the glitchy area that I found at the waste recycling center, where I took a auto load trailer in to try and sell bales, and it doesn't work. I can't get anything to sell there. So I think that's just a skill issue on my part. But when I went to sell the bales, my tractor did some weird stuff. And my auto trailer went kapoof. Don't really know what happened there. So I'm gonna try and work that out, but I'll do that off video. Because I'm gonna have to take a. What I'm gonna have to do is I'm gonna have to take a front end loader with a bale fork and do it that way and put them where I can reach them. And then those I'm probably just gonna sell. But we'll see how much straw and hay we have left after TMR is done. Because I'm not gonna use any of any straw for TMR. The only thing I'm gonna use the straw for is the bed for the cows. So any straw that gets left over is going to be sold. I don't know if I said straw for the bales at the recycling center. If I did, I meant hay, because that was hay, which is what I meant to say. I'm looking at straw right now, so it's confusing. But the hay bales are at the recycling center. So any extra hay and straw we have left over are going to get sold, if we have any. Then we'll go from there. This really quick. I'm gonna try and take this over to field 39 without putting it back on the header trailer, because after this is done I'm going to unlease it and for contracts we'll just get a new one. Cheaper to do it that way because I have so much other stuff to do before I can do contracts. Odds and ends stuff, pretty much. See, here is my field right up ahead here. Trees. That's why I don't really do first person a whole lot. Looks really realistic when you do it though. missing some because of the trees. You can barely see. Okay, I didn't really miss that much. It was like maybe two plants. So we'll go down to this end and get the other little bit that we missed. If I work on that, and I'm going to bring this guy over so that we can dump right away when we're done harvesting. And then I'll take that to the the grain silo, but I'm just gonna do that off camera because we're running out of time here, and so I'll show you guys how much we have in the grain tank there, and then how much we have in the trailer, and you guys can have we'll understand what we'll get from that, and then we'll look at the precision farming aspect of things as well. Should be it. I think I got everything else off the field except for this row. So we can put this in the trailer once we get done here. Did miss a little bit here. So we have 100,000 liters in the grain tank at the silo right now. So 133,899 to be exact. So this should put us about 153,000 roughly. So we can take this stuff back to the store. We don't need it anymore. Now, if we look at precision farming, look how we did on the fields here. So, economic analyst, field 73. We used 815 liters of lime, which equals out to $1,833. We were in the negative or in the positive there because I'm gonna say negative because it makes more sense. We're in the negative there for what was on the field before, so that's good. And then mineral fertilizer, we used 100. I used 1,436 liters. That's $2,297 minus 10%. So we're still in the green there. We go down to fuel. 559 liters was used, $698. Vehicle maintenance, 1,203. AI helper, 384. So in total, we spent 10,800 or 108,400, which is 50. And we got, oh no, that was the yield, sorry. 54.2 tons off of that field, which would equal out to, if we sold it right now, $57,000. So total cost, $6,415, which is $744 above where we should have been. Total earnings, 57. So we came out ahead on that field. If we look at the yield, wasn't too bad, wasn't terrible. If we go to field 31 or field 11, soil samples taken 9, that was $1,575. Lime 666, nice number, $149. Mineral fertilizer 153 liters, $245, and we used 700 or 78.8 liters of fuel, which is $98. Vehicle maintenance of $71, and we had a yield of 5.6 tons, which is $5,998 if we sold it right now, for a total cost of $2,138. We just came out ahead by $85 on that field, so that field's we might need to do something different with that. But you gotta remember, I didn't roll. Either I don't remember liming, which I probably did do, I just don't remember it. And then on field 57, we barely broke ahead. We had 13 soil samples, $2,275, 1,834 liters of lime, which is 2.2 tons. For 14 or $412, which is up 3%. Mineral fertilizer 193 liters for $308, negative or minus 22%, which is good. But then we go down to fuel 70 liters, $87. Vehicle maintenance $60. Yield was not bad. It just broke, just went over even by 1%. So 7,000 is what we've earned from that field. So our total costs were up above where they should have been, and so we did come out ahead by $84 in that field. And then the two fields down here that I just did, we got field 21, which again we came out ahead by a little bit, and then field 39, which again, we barely just came out ahead. So wasn't a bad harvest this year for the first harvest. So what I'll do is I'll next video, I'll get the straw off the field. We're gonna bale the straw, and I'll use a probably use a baler for windrower on it just to make it quicker. And we'll save the straw because that's gonna get sold. And then we'll make TMR and start cattle. So If you guys like this video, if you guys like my hilarious content, please give me a like and a subscribe if you're not already, and a share would be greatly appreciated. Until then, I will see you guys next time.